Hey everyone, this is me, Sadia, here, and I'm back with another reading, which is going to be soulmate reading for whoever needs it. So in this reading, we are going to tap into the soulmate's energy, like what are they doing in their life right now? What are their, you know, feelings, thoughts, emotions towards you? Then we're going to tap into the, you know, a message for, you know, that they have to, you know, a secret message that they have for you. And then we're going to take one oracle card as well. So yeah, let's dive into the reading. But before I do that, let me remind you, that is a general reading. It may not resonate with everyone out there. So always pick the messages which are resonating and leave the rest. For personal readings, you can always reach out to me on my email ID in the description box. You can also follow me on Instagram where I do upload daily readings. So yeah, let's dive into the reading. Let's see what is your soulmate's current energies overall in their life. What are they up to in their life right now? As I could see the Eight of Pentacles, maybe for some of you, your person is so busy and caught up with their work scenarios right now. Maybe they are working towards their, you know, financial stability. Maybe they are working towards another goal in their life. But they are definitely working towards something, keeping themselves busy right now. Let's see more cards. Let's see what are your person's, your soulmate's current energies. What are they up to right now in their life? Let's see. Knight of Swords, Six of Cups, Knight of Wands. I feel like, you know, they are working towards a goal, which is something related to their passion. Something that they're passionate about, be that in work scenario, be that in love life, be that, you know, in any other area of their life. I feel like, you know, they have been working towards their goal. A childhood dream could be the case for some of you as well. They have a passion maybe they have a childhood dream. With the Six of Cups underneath, you know, between the two of the cards here, it seems like, you know, your person is pretty much working towards their childhood dream. But I feel like, you know, somehow with these energies here, the Knight of Swords and the Knight of Wands, your person doesn't know the perfect way to reach to what they are working towards. And that's why the energies is like, you know, it seems like, you know, whatever it is that your person is doing right now, they are not taking proper action towards it. They are not following the right path towards it. It's more like, you know, they... the steps that they are taking is like very immature, and they are not understanding how and what they should do to make it work quicker, to make it work perfectly for them. So I feel like, you know, they have been very immature towards whatever they are planning to do right now. Be that, you know, something in your love life, in their love life with you, or be that in a career or financial situation that they are dealing with or they are working towards. They are unable to take solid steps forward because they are, it's more like, you know, immature in a way or two. And they really need to understand that, they, you know, if it's a childhood dream that they want to pursue, they have to be, you know, they have to go about it with the mature attitude, not like a childhood or childlike attitude towards it, because they have to take serious steps towards it. Otherwise, it's always going to be the childhood dream for them. So, yeah, let's see what is... your soulmate thinking of you. What are their thoughts, feelings, and emotions for you right now? I feel like, you know, your person, like, you know, your soulmate is also picking up fights with the or arguments for their passion with the people around them. Maybe, you know, if it is a passion that they are pursuing regarding their work or, you know, financial goals, I feel like, you know, maybe they are picking up fights around, you know, that with maybe the people that they are working with. Or if not, then they might be picking up fight or argument with their family members. But I do see that too. Let's see what's their, you know, what are their feelings and emotions towards you. Three of Pentacles, the Sun, Eight of Pentacles. They are not thinking or feeling much about you, to be very honest. I can't lie here, because the energies are pretty much clear. Like, you know, this person is too focused on to something. The passion that they have, the work that they have, the childhood dream that they have, they are working towards it non-stop. When it comes to, you know, if they are, it's like you know, I feel like, you know, they are pretty much consumed in their work scenarios. Whatever it is that they're working towards, they are so caught up doing all those things that they don't get enough time to think about their love life. Deep down, maybe they have you, or maybe in the back of their mind, they do have you in their mind, but it's like, you know, I don't see them thinking much about you. For some reasons, I feel like, you know, sometimes it's hard for them to, I feel like, your person, your soulmate is basically having their guards up, or they are basically purposely pulling themselves away from you right now. Why? Because, if they talk to you, if they spend time with you, you are going to be on their mind, which is going to, not let them focus on their work right now, which is why maybe you have already experienced some sort of, pulling away of your soulmate from the situation, from the connection already. Maybe they have detached themselves completely, or they are not talking to or responding you well during, since last few days maybe, or weeks maybe, because I feel like, they really need their focus intact in that one situation, whatever it is that they're working towards. They cannot risk giving you the priority here, which like, it seems like, if they talk to you or if they think of you, you are going to be on their mind for long, which they cannot afford right now for whatever reason. They really want to stay focused on their work. They really want to get to their target goal, because otherwise they are not going to, if they talk to you, if they be with you, no doubt it does make them happy. It does make them feel good. But at the same time, they won't be able to have the focus maintained, or and which they cannot risk right now. Let's see, what is their message for you right now? What do they want you to know? What does your soulmate want you to know? The Emperor, they really want you to know that they are all yours. They have nobody in their life. They are not dealing with another woman or their man right now. They are dealing with something else right now. They are focused onto something else right now. So they really want you to know that I'm all yours. If and when I'm ready to be in a committed relationship, I will marry you. I will come to you. I want a future with you. I want to have babies with you, children with you. But right now, I'm not at all into that scenario or in that mindset where I could pursue my love life. They really want you to know that they are all yours. They love you. They have feelings for you. They have emotional attachment with you. They already feel committed to you deep down. Maybe they haven't said that to you, but yes, that's how it is for them. But they cannot make a move towards you right now, because they really want you to understand that they really need their space so they could get done with this, and then only they will come forward to propose you. Wow, Ace of Cups. They do have strong emotional bond with you, and which you might not be able to see right now, because I feel like, they are not thinking much about you right now, because deep down they know once they get done with whatever it is that is keeping them busy, they will come forward to you with a proposal, and you are going to accept it because you have already committed to them from deep within. Your souls are already tied. You are husband and wife already. But yes, there are scenarios and circumstances right now which is basically not letting you two to come together. But they really want you to know that they have love for you and only you. Let's see one more card here. Three of Wands. They really want you to wait, because that's what they are also doing. They're really waiting on for, situation to improve, where they could be like, they are just waiting for the favorable situation, which can let them pursue this connection the way they want. They really want to get married and have kids with you. But at the same time, they want to get done with this. Let's take one, what's underneath the deck? The High Priest. You and them are already connected in spiritual realm. That's what I'm picking up. Like, it's like, maybe in the physical world you don't see it, but in ethereal world it has already happened. It has already happened. You are already husband and wife. Your souls are already tied. That's what I'm picking up. So they really want you to wait on for them. They don't want. Really, I feel like, you could be connected with them spiritually. You could pick up their vibes easily. And they are asking you to just wait on for them, because they are waiting for something, and as soon as it happens, maybe they are waiting for this to end, as soon as it happens, they would be able to come forward and propose to you and live a happy married life with you. Yes, there are certain delays right now, but eventually it's all going to go away. Let's see what the Oracle has to add to the reading for you guys for this soulmate feed. Let's see what is the spiritual Oracle guidance. We are also going to take some... maybe romance with Oracle cards. Okay, let's see. First, let's pull out two cards from this deck. One and two. Let me take. Okay, so let's take two romance and Oracle cards as well. Let's see what it has to add to the reading. Wow. Okay, we're gonna take both the cards. I can't see this card either, but Yeah, let's start with this card here. Step out of your comfort zone. I feel like, you know, your soulmate eventually will have to come out of their comfort zone. Maybe they are so, you know, they have to basically. I feel like, you know, your soulmate has to basically maintain both love and work life, because whatever it is that is keeping them busy, they're eventually going to understand that they cannot continue living the life that they are living, and they ultimately will have to open up to balance both the areas of their life. This could be, you know, a message for you as well. Maybe for you, you really have to you know, step out of your comfort zone and do something which can speed up this, you know, situation in your love life. Especially if you're waiting for, you know, your soulmate to enter in your life, you really have to go out and be about and let the new person enter in your life, especially if you're waiting on for a new person in your love life and who you believe could be your soulmate. Have faith in your dreams. I don't know, purple or violet color, or, you know, the any shade of purple is going to be lucky for you as well. Plus, I feel like, you know, it's going to keep you intuitively heightened to receive messages coming from your spouse or your soulmate. But yes, even though they are not thinking of you and the connection that you have with them right now much, but you are theirs and they are yours. They have this, like, you know, there is this sense of satisfaction in this connection, which is why, you know, even if things are going slow and delayed, there has to have, you know, you both have to have, you know, faith. I feel like, you know, your person is kind of, you know, very clear about it, or maybe you are very clear about it, that yes, eventually it's gonna happen. And maybe your person really needs to come out of this, you know, situation where they are basically trying to keep things easy for them. They are not pursuing their love life because they want to get done with one area of their life and then they're going to pursue love. If that, you know, whatever the case is, somebody has to step out of comfort zone and the other person has to have faith in the dreams that they have. I feel like, you know, maybe this message is for you, and maybe you have to stay, you know, have a strong faith and keep feeding your faith instead of, you know, feeding your fear around this connection that you have with your specific someone. Release your ex. The time has come to clear your energy, and then we do have romantic feelings. Your feelings are real and worth exploring. For some of you, if you really want to manifest somebody new, you really have to step out of your comfort zone to let this new person enter in your love life. You really have to. In that situation too, the messages from your soulmate is pretty much the same. It's just that you will have to wait for your soulmate to enter in your life. While you wait, you have to clear out the negative energy from the past that you might have had with your ex or something. Treat this new person who's going to enter in your love life in a new and beautiful way. Don't treat them for your past, you know, don't punish them for your ex's past mistakes. Don't do that. Romantic feelings, your feelings are worth exploring and real. So, I feel like, you know, the feelings that you feel for your soulmate is pretty much real and worth exploring. And I feel like I said, you know, if you know that, if I tell you, you and the person that you love, who you believe is your soulmate, you are already married up in heaven. And it's like, you know, it's going to come through in your reality very soon. How would you feel? You would just, you know, relax about the circumstances that are currently happening in your life right now with this specific someone. That's exactly what your attitude should be like, because you both are destined to be. You are already husband and wife. And if you have any issues, any fear around, you know, what's going to happen next? How is it going to happen? How is that going to happen? How this person is going to change? When will they change? Stop asking all those questions, which basically, you know, just pull you away from the alignment of what you desire. If you have a firm belief that this is your person, this is your soulmate, you are destined to get married, you really have to be in that sense of calmness. And, you know, there will be, like, you know, the satisfaction from within, where you're not fearful around, you know, what if they start dating another person? What if this happens? What if that happens? Those questions, those you know, negativities creep into your mind when you have fears. And when you have fears, you cannot have faith. So they both don't coexist in one situation. Like, you know, if you are fearful, definitely you are not, you know, your faith is not strong. So you really have to be, you know, mindful of that energy. So just feed your faith in this situation and let things happen. And Let the wish that you have around your soulmate come to fruition. So yeah, that's pretty much it coming up for you for the soulmate read. If the reading resonated with you, do like, subscribe and share it to my channel. So yeah, till I do the next stream for you guys. Take care. Bye-bye.